Travel, Making Daydreams Come True, written and narrated by John Rayburn. Travel is one thing, but really going somewhere is something else. Here are first-hand tales of exciting places to see in the U.S., Canada, Mexico, Europe, and the United Kingdom. There are exciting visits told here, such destinations as Zermatt, Switzerland, and its proximity to the Matterhorn, one of the world's most famous mountains. In your mind's eye, you can walk down the fabled Mayflower steps at the Plymouth, England departure spot of the historic village to the New World. You can visualize the awesome lavender display near Aix-en-Provence in France, move along the Côte d'Azur, and try to spot Nessie at Scotland's Loch Ness. All this and much more for an outstanding listening adventure. Learn historical background information that will enhance your travel imagination as told with personal observations and anecdotes. Be tempted to see some amazing places, or to see them again if you have already been there. The manuscript beginning is a truism. The world is a book, and those who do not travel read only one page. St. Augustine. Based on that long-ago quote, these stories originate from personal visits to a wide variety of destinations. The primary purpose is to entertain you by offering history and background of the many locales. Let the above comment, "Those who do not travel read only one page," become a thing of the past, as you do indeed hear more than one page in vicarious fashion. Chapter 1, Wanderlust. In essence, that chapter title could be termed farsickness as an antonym for homesickness. It is an intense means of providing self-development by confrontation with unexpected challenges or experiencing unknown cultures and ways of life. Country singer Willie Nelson wrote a best-selling song that said, in part, "On the road again, going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again, and I can't wait to get on the road again." A few years back, I saw a startling statistic that said in our most mobile society on Earth that 50% of the people in the U.S. had never been outside their home state. A newer stat shows 37% of U.S. adults have never moved from their hometown. That syndrome isn't just here. Once in Hawaii, we met a couple from Bristol, England, which lies across the Bristol Channel from South Wales. They had a successful business and had vacationed in such exotic places as Costa del Sol in the south of Spain. However, they hadn't been to Scotland, where a quick flight to Glasgow would only have covered just a bit over 300 miles. Our aim is to provide either vicarious journeys to places you haven't visited or to stir up pleasant memories about some of your favorite destinations. Let's begin with a trip on the Going to the Sun Road, a relatively short 52-mile stretch that crosses the Continental Divide at about 7,000 feet altitude in the midst of Glacier National Park in Montana. The park abuts the Canadian province of Alberta and a smidgen of British Columbia, and there are enough wonders to leave a lot of visitors speechless. To call it rugged landscape would be putting it mildly, and it more than lives up to a description by Native Americans when they called it the backbone of the world. It had sheltered valleys and plentiful food that provided lures for people dating back almost 10,000 years. As a matter of fact, the land was controlled in the 18th century and much of the 19th by the Blackfoot tribe. Experts have said mountains in this glorious example of natural grandeur began forming 170 million years ago. The park itself was established in 1910 and covers around 1 million acres. The two-lane Going to the Sun Road would be quite an engineering accomplishment if done today, but it seems well-nigh impossible in retrospect when it was built in the 1930s. There is a highfalutin term of the hydrological apex of North America concerning the Triple Divide Peak, and that means that water flows from there into the Pacific, Atlantic, and Arctic Oceans. One jaunt took us east out of Spokane, Washington, onto Scenic Highway 2, across Idaho, and eventually to West Glacier, where we made our way into the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.